Hi, I'm Jordy. I run the YouTube channel Cinecom, on which we've recently published a brand new short film called The Game of Life. Now, it's in collaboration with Adobe, and the story is about a researcher who's going to make a very big discovery. Some of the shots have VFX, including this particle tornado, and I'm going to show you how we created this inside Adobe After Effects on an Apple MacBook Pro with a brand new M1 chip, which is going to give us tremendous amount of power. Now, Adobe and Apple have been working together to take the most out of the M1 chip with their Creative Cloud apps, so let's see how they work. All right, we're gonna start off by creating a new solid and throw the CC particle world effect onto it. Now, we don't really need the guides as we don't use it in an actual 3D space, so we'll just disable those. Now, before we're going to start on the particles, I'm gonna go over to Extra and check Composite with Original and then change the blending mode of the solid to Screen. And this is gonna allow us to bring the particles behind the talent. You can see this if we move the producer position. It's a really quick way to solve that issue of the particles needing to go around the talents. All right, so let's expand the physics and the particle property. We have to choose how the particles need to move around and what the particles look like. For the animation, we'll choose viscose to give them a more of a random movement. The gravity is going to be set to 0 as we don't want them to fall down. And I'm going to set the velocity to 0.1. This is how the particles move outwards. I don't want that, but I also don't want them to sit absolutely still. That's why the very small value. And you know, that's pretty much it. You can always play around with the other settings if you're looking for a different kind of movement. The particle cloud is pretty small, but before we're going to make that bigger, I'm already going to set the particle type to faded sphere, as that is going to give us a better view when we're making these changes. Under producer, we can increase the radius for X, Y, and Z to take up the space better. Now, as for the particle itself, it comes in and out. It's called the birth and death. Pretty dark for a virtual particle. But anyways, we can choose the size and the color of those two states. And that way you have more dynamic in your particle system. All the way down under Extra, Effect Camera, we can animate the rotation. So I'll set the keyframes for the rotation Y-axis. There's also a field for the view option to match the particles more with the type of lens that you made your shot with. And that's pretty much it for the animation. Now you probably think now it doesn't really look so good. Well, it needs some fine tuning. First of all, let's enable motion blur for the particle layer. That's already going to make a huge difference. Now, it still looks pretty flat, so we'll add a glow to it. Play around with the threshold, radius, and intensity to give the particles a neutral glow and make them pop more. And now comes the real magic. We're going to look for the CC vector blur. Now, increase the amount a little bit, which will make them appear more like atoms or strings or something, you know, just make them look more science. Now, it's already starting to look really awesome, and as you notice, things still go super smooth in After Effects, even though that we've been working with so many effects. And that's the power of the Apple M1 chip and how well After Effects works with it. Now, finally, I would like to add some nebula clouds, and this will add more of a depth to it as well. Super simple. I'll duplicate the tornado layer, and I will simply increase the birth and death size of the particles. If the glow is there too much, we can disable that for a moment or even get rid of it altogether. Now we'll change the colors of the particles as well to something more purple, blue, and the vector blur we can increase as well. We also want to offset this nebula, which we can do from the random seed option, and that's pretty much all there is to it. Now, the final touch is going to be some heat waves coming off from those particles. We'll create a new adjustment layer and look for the wave warp effect. Drag that to an adjustment layer. Now, we don't want it to affect the entire shot, so we'll draw a rough mask around the middle and make sure to feather it, of course. We can now change the wave height and mostly the wave width. Now, it has to stay subtle. Finally, choose a wave speed, and it will automatically animate so you don't need to place any keyframes. And that, my dear creatives, is how you can create a particle tornado, a little cosmos as described in the short film. So definitely check it out, as well as the other 3 tutorial videos about my short. Links can be found in the description down below. Thank you so much for watching, and as always, stay creative.